This is a poem written by Yunus Emre, who's probably the most famous Sufi poet in Turkey up to this present day. He lived, he was a contemporary of Rumi, but Rumi, who although he is well known because he lived in Konya in Turkey, wrote in Farsi, which is the literary language of the time. Yunus Emre wrote in vernacular Turkish, and he lived there in the end of the 13th, beginning of the 14th century, and actually you go to Turkey and there's hospitals, streets, parks, squares. I mean, you know, everything is named after Yunus Emre. He's the poet laureate of Sufi poets in Turkey. This poem that he wrote is about a person called Uvaysal Karni, who was, the story goes that he lived in the time of the Prophet Muhammad, and he was a great lover of the Prophet Muhammad because he had seen him in spiritual dreams. He'd never met him in person. And he lived in Yemen, and he was looking after his mother. And he asked his mother's permission to go travel to Medina, where the Prophet Muhammad lived at that time, and go visit him. So he obtained his mother's permission. He was a camel herder. And he traveled to Medina, and it just so happened that but he promised his mother that he would come back immediately and not stay for any length of time. So when he got there, he realized that the Prophet Muhammad was out on an expedition and would not be back for a considerable amount of time with his people. So as he had promised his mother that he would return, he returned back to Yemen without seeing him. And then when the Prophet returned after a while, he gave the people, he gave, called two of his closest companion, his cousin Sayyidina Ali and his and Omar, and which were two of the closest companions that he had, and he gave them a cloak, a robe, and he said, take this robe to Yemen and take it to Faisal Karani, to Uvaysal Karni. And so they went to Yemen to meet Uvaysal Karni, and they asked around about him, and finally, because he was very hidden, he kept himself very hidden, but finally they they found him, and they came to him and they said, you know, the Prophet, he brought you this robe. And he looked at and he says, and he looked up at them and he says, do you know who the Prophet Muhammad is? And they looked at him, you know, kind of surprised, because they were close companions of the Prophet Muhammad. Oh, we did not know. And Umar said, yes, of course, I see him, you know, when I'm in Medina, I see him every day. And Sayyidina Ali, he stopped for a moment and he looked at him and he realized and he said, I only saw him once in my lifetime. And Umar was completely perplexed. He said, what do you mean? We stayed with him any day. No, he said, one day he came to me and he took me and he lifted me up. And at that point, he lifted me up and the heavens opened up for me. And I saw his true stature, which reached beyond the horizons. His spiritual presence reached beyond the horizons. And he said, and that's when the one time that I truly saw who he was. And Faisal Karani nodded his head and said, yes, that's who he is. And because and so he became the spiritual patron saint of those who receive spiritual transmission through spiritual means, but never physically actually meeting their teacher or the one who transmits it to them. But they can receive spiritual transmission in the unseen. It's called an Uwaisi transmission in Sufism. And so after that, he ended up traveling, you know, for many years. It was very much what we call a zahid or an ascetic. And he finally ended up in what's now Eastern Turkey and is buried there. And his makam, his grave is still visited a lot. But his cloak, the cloak that Prophet Muhammad gave him, was kept by his descendants. And every year, and it was brought, eventually his descendants who lived in Eastern Turkey gave it to the Ottoman Sultan. And he built a mosque for it in Fatih in Turkey, and every year during Ramadan they bring out this cloak which is 1400 and, you know, 41 years old, and they bring it out, and people come from all over. I mean, we live down the street from there, just around the block, and people, for the last few Ramadans, and people line up around the block, come for blocks and blocks, coming to see this cloak that has been there for all these years.
So this is the poem about him, about Faisal Karani.
Faisal Karani. Faisal Karani. canto suena y ester sereni hakna sipe ise komşu olanı yemen ellerinde Faysal Karani yemez haramı bilmez yalanı kabe yollarını gülü reyhanı yemez haramı bilmez yalanı olay Allah'u sadık yaranı bilmez yalanı kabe yollarını gülü reyhanı yemez haramı bilmez yalanı ol Habib Allah'u